Hey fam, welcome back to the Phillip Scott Show. I am Wongel Zelalem bringing you this story. Today's story is about Naomi Campbell saying that she had to sacrifice finding a soulmate for her successful modeling career. And frankly, I think it's worth talking about. First of all, I want to say that I respect her for telling us the truth. Usually, unfortunately, people don't share the honest truth with young girls when it comes to what they had to sacrifice to become as successful as they are. So from the get-go, the fact that she told us that the one thing she sacrificed to be this successful in her career is a soulmate, I like this because now younger girls that look up to her can decide for themselves what they are willing to sacrifice and not. Why I'm saying that is because mostly we hear specifically women that made it in life career-wise or success-wise, they don't share with younger girls what they had to sacrifice, the amount of time they had to spend in their career. So they neglected their family, kids if they have kids, or friends. So there is a sacrifice that comes with it. You might think it's a no-brainer, they should know. No, not everything is as simple as that. Common sense is sometimes not so common for some people because you have to have life experience, you have to have mentors, or at least watched enough YouTube videos, TED Talks, and read books for you to understand what exactly is in it. By it, I mean success and whatever success is to you. So for you to specialize on something or be great at what you do, you have to give it time. You have to do it again and again every day, you know. You have to sacrifice sleep and all that. So for her to share this, I think it's wonderful because now girls can decide if that's something that they want to do. I'm not saying it's always the case. You know, you have to sacrifice your soulmate or your family in order for you to be successful. Not necessarily, but the amount of success you want might be limited to that because, for example, if you want to be the best at that specific thing, you have to work maybe 20 hours a day and you only get 4 hours of sleep. At that time, how can you fit in a husband, children, or even keeping up with your family and friends? It's going to be harder. But if you are willing to sacrifice some of the success, not all of it, just if you would have been the number one champion, maybe now you become the third, and you minimize the time that you would give your work or your career and, you know, add on more responsibilities like being married and have kids and still be close to your family and friends, that is also possible. But you have to balance. For you to balance, that might mean you won't be the best at what you want to do. So I know it sucks, especially if you're a woman, because like you have to take a break to have kids. You have to, you know, make sure that the house is also taken care of. Like there's more added to women if you want to also be a career woman, as well as be involved in your household and make sure that you give time to your husband and your kids. So it is going to be harder, but the good thing is you can balance it as much as it is hard for you. So I wish she also told us if she regrets it or if she's happy with it, or also went a little bit deeper and tell younger fans and people that look up to her and tell them that I did sacrifice, but it's not for everyone, because we have to keep that in mind too. Sacrificing marriage and family for career is not for everyone. Very few people are able to do that, especially if you're a woman, because we want to be with someone, we want a relationship, we want a meaningful relationship, not just, you know, a hookup. Because for men, I guess they can go on for a little longer by just hookups and just, you know, no strings attached kind of relationship. But as women, and also the people around me, the people I have seen, of course, I haven't met every woman in the world, so I can't speak for everyone. But for most women that I know of personally, we need a relationship, or we need to be in a meaningful partnership. So losing that, sacrificing that for work might not work for our kind of personality. So for us to get this heads up from someone that came before us and worked hard and, you know, made this success, she is an icon, right? So for her to tell us this puts things into perspective, and you can decide based on that, okay, am I willing to sacrifice a soulmate for my career? If the answer is no, make sure to, you know, put your eggs in many baskets, balance the things that you want to see thrive, and then you can decide eventually if you want to quit this one or the other one. But as for me personally, I think balancing is the way to go, as hard as it is for me personally. But for some women, as I said, they are okay with not having a family and just focusing on their career. But anyways, that's why I brought this topic, because I think it is important to educate young girls what they will sacrifice if they're willing to just put everything in one basket and just focus on their career. So Naomi Campbell is the best example for that. Anyways, guys, let us know down below what your thoughts are about Naomi Campbell coming out and actually telling us that she sacrificed having a soulmate for her career. I'm Wongel Zelalem, bringing you the story. I will see you on the next one. Bye.